गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज भूषण देशमुख, क्लास 7th सब्जेक्ट साइंस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स, राइट? मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स, ओके. फ्रॉम द टॉपिक natural resources, okay. Lesson number 16, natural resources, okay. Now we have already learned about minerals and ores, right? Today we are going to learn about some important minerals and ores, right? First one is iron ore, right? Now let us understand what is meant by iron ore. Iron ore, iron occurring in the impure state is called iron ore, right? Iron that is occurred in impure state, right, is called iron ore. Iron ore is used to make a variety of articles from pins to heavy machinery, right? What we can make from iron ore? We can make pin, right, vehicles and heavy machineries, right? From pin to heavy machineries, where that iron is required, that can be formed from the iron. For example, farming implements, rails of railway tracks, right? These are things can be made from the iron ore. The four main ores of iron are magnetite, hematite, limonite and siderite, right? These are the four main iron ores of iron ore, right? Now second one is manganese. Now what is meant by manganese? Manganese occurs in the form of carbonate, silicate and oxide, right? It is carbon, silicate and oxide. Compounds of manganese are used in the preparation of medicines, for giving pink tint to glass. Manganese is also used in electrical appliances, right? It is also used in electrical appliances. That is, the silicon is widely used in electrical appliances, right? So there are the compounds of manganese are carbonate, silicate and oxide, in the form of carbonate, silicate and oxide, right? Third one is bauxite. Now here you can see the example of manganese, right? This is silicon. It is a transistor in which silicon is used, right? Bauxite. Bauxite is the most important ore of aluminium, right? It contains 55% aluminium. Bauxite consists mainly of aluminium oxide. Aluminium is a very good conductor of electricity and heat. Its density is low, therefore it is used mainly in aeroplanes, transport vehicles and to make electrical wires. Here this is the aluminium wire, right? Aluminium wire, here also used aluminium, right? Why aluminium is used? Why aluminium is used? Because it is very good conductor of electricity and heat, and its density is low. Now fourth one is copper. Copper is found in the impure state in the vicinity of iron and other minerals. Copper is a very good conductor of electricity, therefore it is used to make electrical wires, as well as in radios, telephones, vehicles, for making kitchen utensils and statues, okay. Now fifth one is mica. Mica is a bad conductor of electricity. Its value depends on the thickness of its layers. Mica has many uses such as in Ayurvedic medicine, dyes, electrical machines and equipment, wireless communication equipment, etc. Okay. Now revise these five main important minerals and ores. Then I will ask you question based on it. Okay. I will give you 5 minutes for revision. Okay. Revise it. Then I will ask you questions. Okay, students, have you revised? Now I will ask you questions. Now first tell me, what is iron ore? Rule number 32, tell me what is meant by iron ore. Right, iron occurring in the impure state is called iron ore, right? Now rule number 12, tell me what can we make from iron ore, or where does iron ore is used? Right, iron ore is used to make from pin to heavy machinery, right? For example, farming implements, rails of railway tracks, etc. The four main ores of iron are magnetite, hematite, limonite and siderite. Okay. Now, rule number 7, tell me what is manganese? Right. Manganese occur in the form of carbonate, silicate and oxide. Compounds of manganese are used in the preparation of medicines. Right. And it is also used in electrical appliances. Now, what is meant by bauxite? Bauxite is the important ore of aluminium, right? It consists of 55% aluminium. Bauxite consists of mainly aluminium oxide. Aluminium is a very good conductor of electricity and heat. Its density is low. Therefore, it is used mainly in aeroplanes. Now, copper. Where does copper is used? Copper is used in for making electrical wires as well as radio, telephones, right? What is mica? Mica is a bad conductor of electricity. Its value depends on the thickness of layers, right? Now, let's try to understand new topic, that is fuel, right? Various substances are used in day-to-day life for generating energy. These substances are called fuels, right? The substances that are used for making energy are called fuels. Substances that are useful for making energy. For making energy are called fuels. Which natural resources do we use as fuels? We use sun, right? Coal, right? Wind, water. These are the natural resources that we used for energy, that we used as fuels in day-to-day life. Now, first one is coal. Millions of years ago, forest got buried underground as a result of certain natural events. Layers of soil kept getting deposit over them. The very high pressure from above and the heat from the earth's interior slowly transformed the buried plants into fuel. Right? Coal was thus formed from the remains of those plants. That is why coal is used as fossil fuels. Right? That is called fossil fuels. Right. Coal is found in mines, peat, lignite, brown coal, bituminous coal, and anthracite are the various types of coal. Anthracite is the coal of the highest grade. Right. Anthracite is the coal of highest grade. Coal is in a way a storehouse of carbon. It is burned to obtain heat energy. Coal is used as fuel. It is used as a fuel in thermal power plant as well as to run boilers and railway engines. Coal is also used as a fuel for cooking and for baking bricks in lines on a large scale. The gases fuel, producer gas and water gas are obtained from the coal. Coal as an energy resource contribute greatly to industrial development. Okay. Now revise this coal. Then I will ask you question on what is meant by fuels, what natural resources do we use in day-to-day life. Okay. And about coal. Okay, student, have you revised? Now tell me what is meant by fuels. Roll number 20, tell me what is meant by fuels. Right. In our day-to-day life, we use substances for generating energy, right? That are called fuels. Now, rule number 3, tell me what are the examples of fuels or what natural resources that we used as fuels. Right, coal, sun, water, wind. Right, that are the natural resources that we used for generating energy. Right. Now, from where do we get coal? Where does coal is found? Right, coal is found in mines. Right. And what is the main type of coal? Which coal is important? High grade coal. Right, anthracite is the coal of the highest grade. Good. Now observe this and discuss. How were minerals, oil and natural gas formed? Natural gas formed, right, millions of years ago, thousands of years ago at present. National institution. The oil and natural gas ONGC was established on 14th August 1956. It functioned under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas of the Government of India. ONGC is the largest oil and gas research and production company in India. Its head office is at Dehradun, Uttarakhand. ONGC produces about 77% of the crude oil and about 62% of the natural gas produced in India. Of the 7 commercially important underground oil reserves in India, ONGC has successfully explored 6. Right. Mineral oil and natural gas. Now let us understand what is meant by mineral oil. Mineral oil is the liquid fuel formed by the decomposition of organic substances buried underground. Millions of years ago, bodies of the dead sea organisms sank to the bottom of the sea. Layers of the soil and sand collected on them. Due to high pressure and temperature, the remains of the dead organisms were transferred into mineral oils. The underground mineral oil is extracted through oil wells. Mineral oil is found mainly in the oil sands, shale, sandstone and limestone at the depth of 1000 to 3000 meters. Mineral oil is also known as petroleum crude oil. It is greenish brown in color. Petroleum is a mixture of many compounds, mainly of the hydrocarbon type. It is also contains compound of oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur. Petroleum is extracted through oil wells and refined by fractional distillation to separate other components. Aviation, petrol, gasoline, diesel, kerosene, naphtha, lubricating oil, tar, all obtained from petroleum. They are used as fuel for production of dyes, pesticide, perfumes and artificial fibers. Okay. Now in next class we will learn about natural gas. Okay. If you have any difficulty, you can ask. Okay. Okay, thank you, students.